I like the stars idea.
Yeah, it's really nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. The first thing I ever wanted to be was an astronaut.
Whatever
this is going to be, I'm not quite sure.
Yeah, the idea is that you're going to lift it up and then someone else somewhere will be tied. So the idea is that it looks like you just lift and then you let go.
I've got this debate. I've got to stay late after school. I've got this debate. It's on Tuesday. It's about the objectification of women in media. I'm fighting on the side of modesty. You'll be really proud. I'm a performer, a writer, improviser, actor, and I live in Brooklyn. It worked in rehearsal that one time.
Yeah.
I see it in so, not just Islam, but like across the board.
Sure.
And I think that every time there's a costume that's conservative and associated with religion, and then you see that person in the costume wearing jeans.
Yeah.
Or doing something that you wouldn't think a religious person would do, your stereotype of that.
Like the Pope in his tennis gear.
Can you believe that? Oh, wow, that's really easy to put on. That's a true one piece.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of the time you have to do shit to it.
Oh my God, I'm just getting ready.
My parents tried to live in Long Island. My dad hated it. He's like, yahan kuch nahi chalta, log bakwas hain. He just couldn't, so we moved to Hertfordshire, a suburb of London.
Why are you shy?
I love telling stories, but you know, as a parent, you should be able to see, oh, my kid's really into stories. She's a storyteller. Maybe we should like develop that in her and nurture it and encourage it. But it was always seen for the end result of, oh, she's going to be a really good wife.
I love you, you're the daughter of the household. That's Horam over there.
Where I grew up in a really strict Muslim hole Pakistani home. There was no Western influence that came into our home. My parents didn't even want us to speak English in the home. So when we were kids and me and Khoran would be like, Mom, what are you doing? My parents would be like, Awaaz aa rahi hai kahin se? Koi awaaz aa rahi kuch hua hai? And like, they wouldn't respond to us unless we spoke to them in Urdu. There were such conflicting values around what it meant to be normal, what it meant to be okay. My dad would show me these newspaper clippings of white girls that had been raped and be like, this is what happens to these ghoulies. Because I think it was an evolving fear. I don't think that he came to the West with fear. I think it was seeing the contrast between our values and the Western values once you're there.
Nadia, beti, remember, you must join the Islamic society immediately. Huh? It's very good to be with your own kind. This is the Quran, your leaving gift. And I have created and laminated a list of rules for you to live by while you are at university. You are not permitted to break any of these rules.
There was a lot of fighting, there was a lot of threats, there was a lot of just abuse, a lot of abuse, emotional abuse. And you know, when my mum died, my family definitely fell apart.
You listen, yeah? You don't even know who you are anymore. I mean, look at you. What do you know about family? Khurram, I'm your twin sister. Nah, you ain't. My sister is dead.
Ammi? Oh, Mama, can you get Ammi?
This is the first time I've been home in 8 months. And before that, it was almost 10 months before I came home. My parents moved to the US when I was less than a year old. Though I grew up mostly on the East Coast, growing up as a Pakistani American, I know what I faced while staying in Pakistan. It's like if you imagine 1989, like Pakistan 1989, like in a snow globe, and you just take that, you put it in your suitcase and you bring it with you. And then every time you have a question about what to do, you refer back to the snow globe and say, well, what did it look like in 1989? And to some extent, that's how you're raised.
I just asked my mom.
I did what I was supposed to do. I was traditionally successful. I did well in school. You know, I went to MIT. You know, I graduated. I went to Wall Street. And I didn't find a whole lot of value in it. Probably because I wasn't doing it for the right reasons.
That is a cold egg.
It's unfortunate in our communities. We spend a lot of time tearing people down that are different. And you know, letting them know exactly what we think about the fact that they're not good at this or they're not good at that, rather than sort of supporting them on their way, because no one's going to get very far if they're just being torn down at every turn. I felt a lot of ways that my life was closing in around me because I couldn't do anything but basically take orders for the rest of my life. For me, it manifested itself as depression. I was a scared and sad little girl who didn't know what to do with her life, that was very confused, that heard a lot of voices and a lot of criticism coming from a lot of different directions. How did I deal with it? I escaped. About a year and a half ago, I moved out to Portland, Oregon to train with the U.S. national coach. I'm the first Pakistani fencer.
I want to be world champion. I mean, will I be world champion? I didn't start the sport at 8. If I don't end up being world champion, then I hope I can pave the way for a Pakistani world champion. And I know, realistically, it's quite likely I won't be, but that's what I want. I'm going to give it all because what else would I be spending my time and life on? You know, I could be killing myself on Wall Street. Again, same thing or like before?
You just really see all the situation, right? Bam, bam, bam. There you go. Is it nice?
Well, I am the oldest of 5 total kids.
This is the trolley.
It was a period of time that my family lived there in Pakistan when I was at Georgia Tech.
Well, I got my master's and my PhD here. I got my undergraduate at University of Central Florida.
Hi. So when I was doing my thesis, one of the data sets I worked with, aside from travel and family, when I've gone to compete 2 times to represent Pakistan, I was the only one. As far as wearing the headscarf, that would be the physical thing that someone would see that would make me look different. But in the smaller town, mostly I just had questions about it. When September 2001 occurred, the event with the Twin Towers, I think that's when there was a point after that where things changed and people were staring at me and there was that tension. People would say things that were ignorant and blunt, like, you know, going back to your country or assuming something about me as being terrorist or violent or being oppressed as far as how I appear.
I don't know how to stop it.
I received very sudden media attention that wasn't expected.
Kulsum Abdullah has been lifting in competitions while wearing a hijab, the traditional Muslim headdress that covers the head, arms, and legs. But her attire barred her from competing in major U.S. events because the old rules required arms and legs be bare so judges could verify a successful lift.
The physical toll, I was trying to train the mental, the emotional, dealing with the criticisms. At the beginning, the mail that I got that was negative from both sides would be people who are, you know, asking, why are you doing this? Like, why are you trying to change the rules? If you want to play the sport, you just need to do it and not change them or forget it. Most of the time, I would just ignore it because I felt like it was just going to be wasting my energy if I replied.
Over the years.
Then other criticisms would be, this is not Islamic, you're not practicing hijab, you're standing in front of a mixed audience and doing this weightlifting. You're not doing what a Muslim woman should be doing, it's a masculine thing, it's for men, it's for the sports in general.
My father always hoped that I would follow in his footsteps and, you know, be somebody just like him. You know, it took a long time for him to come to terms with it. He'll still have people ask him what his daughter does, and, you know, I'm sure he hesitates when he answers that. And that makes me feel like self-conscious sometimes about the decisions that I've made. And I wish I didn't have to put my parents in that position where they have to overthink something as simple as an answer concerning their daughter's occupation. To a Pakistani, when I try and explain what I do, it's something so menial and something so beneath everybody. This is our main, this is the main way into the kitchen. Okay. What did you do with the schedule? I've always known that I was meant to be in a kitchen, and I always like sort of dreamed of becoming this like world-class famous chef. I moved here when I was about 18, and I went straight to the Culinary Institute of America upstate. When I was 4 years old, my parents got a divorce, and that's why we sort of split up. So I spent like my school years in Karachi, and then I would fly over to Lahore to go spend time with my father. Who's in for pizza? Do we have to set up pizza right now?
Yeah.
Okay, that you want a very light, fluffy dough. It was always about more having things chosen for you rather than being granted the opportunities to make those decisions yourself. And, you know, I had a bit of both. And I struggled with the sort of aspect of somebody else being in control of what I wanted to do. And that was sort of like the end all be all. Like I wasn't gonna have it any other way. In, you know, like where I wanted to be, who I wanted to be, where I wanted to live, where I wanted to work. Grab that 25 seat one. Correct. So you got a calamari coming? You're gonna meet men in the kitchen who don't want you around because you're a woman. You're gonna meet men in the kitchen who want you around because you're a woman. And then you're gonna meet other women who don't want you around because you're a woman. And I looked at him and I was like, well, chef, where do I go from there? He's like, darling, you go nowhere but up, okay? And I laughed, and I will never forget those words that he told me. And it's true. Yeah.
Oh, Tara just texted. She's like, you stuck on the BQE2.
Amazing! I just saw your text! See you in 10 minutes! So that's pretty amazing. That's my director, Tara.
We must wash the dead body. Nadia! Beta, you must take responsibility for your mom's death.
You should wash your dead mother, it will cleanse your sins. You were seeing this English boy, she was very unhappy.
So burk off is kind of like a metaphor for taking off the traditions that are supposed to define me to be self-defining.
Of course I wasn't right, I had a Pakistani vagina, which means it was so tightly wound up that when it realized its true function, it nearly exploded and killed me in the process.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, or like when I'd come back and I would talk about how I miss my dad or it's hard being away from him, my peers and my friends would say, but you left them.
Yeah, it was your decision to leave, so don't talk about it.
Yeah, and that you left your family was like the worst thing that you could have done. And I always sense a lot of judgment around that.
Some people would like you said.
We're going to the Brooklyn Library to see an immersive piece of theater.
Tara and I are thinking about is having giant samosa,
right? So they actually become part of like the part of the cultural experience of what it means to be watching a Pakistani playwright and performer.
But he decides to stop and look back.
I met an Irish lad when I was 18 called Brendan, who I, first love of my life, fell in love with him, wanted to marry him, you know, very, very sweet romance. But of course, there's no way I could have ever told my family.
Listen, Tonde,
Not unless you want to get stoned to death. Does that sound extreme?
Well, it's not.
I might not have had the murdering type of parents, but 5,000 Muslim girls last year did. Killed off for dishonoring the family name, for being too Western while they are raised in the West. Fathers and brothers strangling their little girls because they were caught talking to a boy on the phone.
Doing a one-woman show. I grew up in London, I'm Pakistani Muslim. It's called Broke Off. It's like a one-woman comedy show about like how I grew up. So I'm just going around like putting cards. You should totally come check it out. It's comedy. I do like 20 characters. Yeah, what's your name?
I hope that by people seeing my show that they're also inspired to have the courage to tell their own stories and to not be afraid of judgment and what people are going to think, and to be able to get up on stages or write books or speak up at their family dining table and be like, I don't agree, you know, whatever that means for that particular person, but to inspire people to that their voice actually has value.
I didn't have parents that, you know, paid for everything and took me to competitions and supported me. I dealt with people telling me, why are you wasting your time? This is useless, this is so expensive. Just give me your money, I'll light it on fire for you. These questions. Fencing is really what brought me close to Islam, and because Islam had always been part of my life. I really respected it, but it wasn't the driving force behind my life by any means.
My life now is surrounded by sports, and that's the odd thing. When I was growing up, my life did not have any sports in them.
Fencing, sports, was a way of solving my personal problems, and that's what motivated me, that's what kept pushing me.
Imagine, you punch someone in the face, they swing, they completely miss, and now he's on the ground. How do you feel? How do you feel?
Yeah,
you feel good. Yeah. Let's say you didn't even want to initiate the fight, but the guy comes toward you, or he did something. I mean, it feels good. That's fencing, except you don't break any noses.
Chicago World Cup is next week. I'm really looking forward to it. It'll be my first international experience as a Pakistani fencer, and I think it'll be great.
Let's do a few times like this, okay? I move. If you see longer distance, you can do double step and lunge, right? But if short,
it's very tactical. You know, they call it physical chess for that reason. You get on the strip with somebody, maybe you've never fenced them before, and immediately you're trying to analyze their game. You're trying to figure out their weaknesses. You're trying to figure out, you know, what are their tendencies? You know, how can I make this? Because, I mean, yeah, you can try to be physical and just run up and down and up and down and stay out of touch until they're just dying and they can't move anymore. But that doesn't make a fencer. That just makes a really, really good athlete.
We have had such specific gender roles, you know, whether it's like male or female, and then everyone else is intended to comply with these gender roles that have been established. People have taken concepts of religion that are wonderful and twisted them in a way so that it suits their own needs. I've gotten so used to it. I have like, my arms are full of them. This week was pretty bad though, I'm not gonna lie. Usually I'm not this beaten up, but I battled with my deep fryer. It spat at me a few times, so. It just looks horrific. Like every time I go on the subway and like I put my hand up, like people, like I can see people like staring at my arm and then looking at my face. Like they probably think I get like beaten. I'm like abused. No. I chose this.
This one here.
I chose this life.
No, it's tenderi. I can't. If you want to look at the top shelf, I can't see.
Like I think God prohibits this. May fall down and you are legal. You may fall down and something may happen. Mm-hmm. So I just, and plus I don't want to. The reason I wasn't coming to your competition, like I don't want to make you nervous either. Like I would be so nervous, I would make you confuse it.
She does get scared. It's hard for her to watch a competition. She thinks I'm going to kill myself. So hopefully she'll be going to the competition.
Yeah.
Coming up at Emory, which will be her first one.
What's not allowed is that you either caught the weight with bent elbows and pressed it out. The IWF representatives that were at the meeting watched my video. I took pictures of myself withholding the weight overhead where my arm was covered, and I compared it to other guys that were also holding a weight overhead and showed side-by-side pictures of the two. So then the morning I got some phone calls and emails, and they issued a statement saying that we're going to allow something called a unitard, which is a one-piece suit that would cover the whole body, the arms and the legs, under the traditional singlet. And they had also said that we've actually always allowed the hijab or the headscarf.
It wasn't just an individual challenge, this was going to be a global challenge, and that it was going to affect women in many countries. Whether or not the reason they couldn't compete, again, not because of just logistical financial reasons, but because of cultural society reasons that were stopping them. I wanted to do this sport, but I fought to try to get my rights to be able to cover for religious reasons and to not give up and to truly try, and I did it. Acknowledge what the fears are and just try to do what we want to do and try to overcome them. We can do things whether or not they're going to be big right away, but over time, trying to stand up for yourself and be confident in what you can do and what you are.
Given that, you know, I wasn't set up for this. To some extent, I wasn't supposed to be here. This is not the life I was supposed to leave. This is not the life I was supposed to lead, but this is the life I made for myself.
There was always a part of me that wanted to also explore different opportunities and not be told where I belong and actually find out for myself where I belong, because that's something that we should choose.
I feel like if people don't fight for what they believe in and actually make that effort, like individually, one by one, then there should be no expectations whatsoever.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have already done so at this time. Please turn off and stow all electronic devices, that is, any device with an on and off switch.
The first thing thing I ever wanted to be was an astronaut.
Women can't be astronauts. Who will cook? Who will clean? Who will feed your husband if you're floating about in space?
Vaginas don't exist in Pakistani homes. Sex is the last topic of conversation. In fact, it's not even a topic of conversation. It doesn't exist. There is no sex in Pakistani homes. Instead, there's this.
Orangabhar se bhige chunarwali rangabhar se.
Ye kya hai? Tumhara dimag kharab hai? Adiba, ye dekho ye kya kar rahi hai. Look at what she's doing. Besharam. Are? What has she been watching? Are? Why are you like this? Why is she like this? Where is your shame? Where is your shame?
Abu. Shame.
Cola is in a red wine and sultana reduction sauce.
How did you feel about the olive loaf? It was something you're not familiar
with. Not at all. I couldn't taste it because it's got pork in it.
Okay.
Well, I have to say, for the one ingredient that you couldn't taste, it was the best thing on the plate. Absolutely fantastic. I love it.
Katie's house, when in fact we were going to Mallorca. Women are responsible for the reputation of the family. We are the carriers of shame.
What would they think of our family? What would they say? We have given her too much freedom. Who knows what else she has done? You're disgusting, yeah? I can't believe you're my sister.
And what are you talking about?
I know, Nadia. I know about Brendan, yeah? I know you've been seeing this son of fucking Gore behind our backs. You're a fucking liar, man. You lie about everything. Ami would be turning in her grave.
Get your hair tied off the floor, sweep it back.
Oh,
yes.
I want to win this. I've traveled really, really far. I'm sorry. I want to win so bad, just to prove that I've made, you know, the right decisions in my life. It would just be like a huge stamp of approval.
Attack was not as good as she does in the club. Formative situation was so not as good, and she was a little bit too tense being in defense. So not perfect. I expect more. And you know, but I know how difficult it is to, you know, go and change this stuff.
Girte hai shahzawar hi maidan-e-jang mein. Wo tifl kya gire jo ghutno ke bal chale. You have to go out, you have to try something, and even if you fail,
it's still better that you tried something. But there is no such thing as failure in what I'm trying to do.
Boundaries still need to be broken in all parts of the world and sectors of society, but the progress is promising. I hope that representing Pakistan at international competitions will help foster more female involvement in sports. It is not about finishing on the winner's podium, but getting to the starting line.
And so I left. Finally. Not through my window and out of my imagination. Not by covering myself up with layers of cloth, nor by taking it all off. But through the front door of my home, one foot in front of the other, with only one possible destination.
Come out really beautifully, I think, as father and daughter. He is my biggest fan, my biggest supporter.